Because you think video games, and you think, oh, this is going to be easy. No, you still have to learn the science. What we love to do with students, and we really want to go do it again, is to take you into the field. We want to take you and have you measure the urban heat island. We want to take you to Tempe Butte and have you learn about interpreting the natural landscape, but we can't do that. And so we turn to video game technologies to simulate what it's like for students to interact with real data.
In this type of learning method, having them go and be in places that they might not have been before, they can interact with these different ideas in a virtual way. So they're doing kind of virtual field work. That's a bit harder if you're just looking at some pictures in a lab book, whereas with this type of technology, we can have them actually go out and visualize this type of idea.
So I'm teaching two classes this semester. One is oral interpretation of literature, which is part of our performance studies. In the most recent assignment in my oral interpretation class, they worked in pairs. So what they did is they used Zoom as their stage. I've seen levels of engagement in my classes that I haven't seen in semesters. They were so creative about how they used backgrounds and placed their bodies in particular ways. They used music and they used sound effects. And we don't often use all those mechanisms, but they really, really were creative in how they made the stories come to life. And so for me, that gets me excited. The possibilities are amazing. And so it's been so much more successful than I anticipated it being. I would give credit to the students for that.
In speech-language pathology, we really needed to get creative with how were we going to maintain our ability to engage in clinical interaction with real patients, clients, and students who need services while maintaining safety.
Prior to the pandemic, we were trying to launch a little bit of telehealth, and then once the pandemic hit and our clinic closed down, we were able to get HIPAA secure Zoom rooms for the faculty and move a large number of our clients into a telepractice environment.
I thought, oh, telehealth, that's remote. It can't possibly be as effective or as good as in-person interactions. Well, with telepractice, we can take these masks off. And our patients who have trouble hearing and our patients who have trouble talking, where they need to be able to see our mouths move, our facial expressions, that is way more effective through telehealth. And that was a surprise to me. I hadn't really thought about it that way, but telehealth has been great.
Now we have to supplement their hours in clinic with doing more simucase. So we're doing a much wider variety of simulations.
Simucases are simulated clinical interactions that emulate a real clinical experience. Those simucases have become much more necessary in order to give students who for a time and still now are not able to get those in-person clinical experiences. So we are able to use the simulated cases to continue to provide robust clinical education. I have been so impressed with students. They have been so flexible.
Students are able to, I think, experience a lot more. Students get to see a wider variety of clients, and they also seem to have more opportunities because it cuts down on some of their travel time.
The synchronous way that we've been learning has allowed for a bit more collaboration between students.
What I'm hoping for is that it will be easier to switch the light bulb, that the video game will give them a different perspective on learning. When you're learning a new concept, the vocabulary is overwhelming. So I think we can help pull that light bulb quicker when they see it in the video game.
I know about their lives. I know about their dogs. I see them. It's just built this really authentic, amazing connection. I mean, it's technology and it's accessibility. People can have access to professors and professors can have access to students. And that's something I think that we should embrace.